Hello guys, Adip here for Movement Science. At this channel, I simplify biomechanics for you guys with Joe. In this video, I'm going to talk about something special. This video I was supposed to post long back, but because of some technical issues, I was not able to post it. So today, I'm going to show you how a gate lab works. Some basics of gate analysis and also something about the instruments that are used inside the gate lab. It's going to be a very short video and just simple introduction to gate analysis. And before we get started, I want to mention that this video was shot at Manipal Diabetic Foot Care Clinic Gate Lab. And special thanks to Dr. Arunji Maya and Dr. Rishikesh sir, who helped me out throughout this video. And this video was possible only because of them. So without any further ado, let's get started. What you can see here is the force plate used for gate analysis. This force plate is 1 meter long and it has 9600 sensors. Each detects weight of 1 kg and displacement of 1 millimeter. Next equipment you can see is the camera, which was taking the video from two views, the anterior and the lateral. So for the movement analysis, we start with the markers. We put markers on the body. These markers are detected on the camera and on the software of the computer. They are placed on the certain points like knee joint, first metatarsal, fifth metatarsal and lateral malleolus. With the markers, the person has to walk on the force plate and the video is taken of the same. And this is how it looks on the computer once markers are detected from the front and the lateral view. Once the data is taken, we can see in the video how it's showing weight distribution on the foot throughout the gait. The red regions take the most amount of weight compared to the yellow region and then the green and blue. Throughout the gait, the load will vary and if there is excess force on any of the region, it can lead to calluses and ulcers depending upon the severity. These forces are taken in both dynamic, that is gait or walking, and static, that is standing with both eyes open and eyes closed. The software can also detect the sway in the COG, that is center of gravity, and it can be compared to eyes closed and eyes open variation in people with balance issues. Apart from this, in gait analysis, we can also track the muscle activity throughout the gait through EMG, that is the electromyography. The electrodes are inserted into the muscle or skin surface electrodes can be used. This can tell us about the concentric, eccentric and isometric muscle activity and moments created at the joint, and all the data together has the potential to give us somewhat the full picture of human gait. Coming back to the kinematics or the movement, inside the software each point is marked with the name and is assigned certain color. These points will be connected and the segments will be formed like a stick figure. Now, when we analyze each point, the computer will tell us about the velocity at which a particular point is moving in the space, and it will also tell us about the acceleration of that particular point. These values vary, so in patients with diabetes where there is damage to the nerves, there can be reduced spatiotemporal parameters that can be accurately detected here.
So this is how a gait lab works. If you really like the video, don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel. And see you soon in the next video.